Now let's learn about a very important concept in Power Apps and also in other programming languages, other softwares. It's the concept of variables. To explain that, I have created a new screen. Right now it's empty, I just put a title, and I'm going to demonstrate a little bit. But first, let's understand how variables work even in real life. Look at this example where we have a box with two fruits, and then we have the name and the price. If I ask you, what's the price of the fruit? You cannot tell me because you don't know exactly which fruit it is. But if I say, what's the name of the orange? the price of the orange. You can look at the name, see that this one is the orange, and then check the price to see that's $3. Now, if I ask you, what's the price of the pineapple? You will look at the name and see the price, that's $4. If we think programmatically, this is the meaning of variables. Variables have a name and a value. So, translating to Power Apps, we will have something like this. We have a name that's called price orange, and then we have the value 3, and price pineapple, and the value 4. This is what we want to create in there, and this is what represents a variable. It's a name that means something that stores a value. And this value could be a number, a text, even a table. Let's see how we could mimic this real-life example in Power Apps. So let's go back to our app. And I have imported two pictures here that are the pictures of the pineapple and the orange. And I will want to set the price and store in a variable called those names that I just showed, price pineapple and price orange. Okay, so right now, if I just insert a label here in the bottom and try to access that information that's called price of something, so price pineapple, I have an error because this doesn't exist in my app. It's not a valid name, but I can create a variable with this name and then it will be valid. So let's try to create something to set this variable. And whenever I use this price pineapple property, I can get the value that has the price. Okay, let's insert a text input. Put right below the pineapple box. Remove this default text, just leave it empty. And now when the user types the price, for example, 4, I want to store this value to the variable. Okay, I will put a button, and on the click of this button, we are going to set that variable. So I just inserted the button right here. And then we have in the onSelect property the possibility to create this function. And it's very simple. It's called set. I type the name of the variable then. In this case, I want it to be called price pineapple. And what's the value I want to associate to this variable, to this name? Is the value that the user just typed here. In this case, let's see, the name is called text input 1. Let me rename to txt pineapple. Make it easier. So now in the bottom, I'm going to set the price pineapple to be txt pineapple.txt. That means the text the user just typed in there. I close the parentheses. And then if I click on play, put a value here and click on the button, I'm going to call the set function and that variable will exist. It means that now we have a variable called price pineapple and its value is 4. Again, if I change the value here and click on the button, this value will change. Notice that I can even delete here. If I don't click in the button anymore, this is the value that will be used through my app, the value number 5. And I can use this to compute other information. For example, I could calculate what's the cost of 3 pineapples. Let's say I want the user to type the amount. Let me just put an input. This would be the amount, so let me remove the default text. And then I want to calculate the total price. Let's insert just a label on top of it so we can understand better. Let's put type how many pineapples do you want? And then the user will type here and we can calculate the total price. So after that, we could put a text saying the total price is, we get the input, this one, text input 2. So I'm going to concatenate, joining with the second part of the string, text input 2 dot text times the price of the pineapple, so price pineapple. Okay, now, since we have the price pineapple set to 5, if I type here, for example, 3, it will compute 3 times 5 and I have 15. Okay, so we are using the variable to compute the price. If I change the price, number 4, for example, and click on set, then the price now is 12. Notice that this variable only exists while the app's being played. If I close the app and open again, it will not exist anymore because it's temporary. And I can use this variable in other parts of my app, since I use the function set. The function set will create a variable that can be used through all the screens of the app. For example, if I navigate to any other screen, for example, this is screen number 4 here, and insert a label and put the price pineapple here, I'm going to see the price of the pineapple because it's using a global variable when I use the set function. So this set creates a variable that's used globally. So I'm going to rename the button, change the text of the button to set, because now we are going to see the second way to create variables that's using the update context. It's a second function. Let me insert a new button. Creating and editing a video like this gives me a lot of work. And I just ask you to subscribe, like, and leave your comments to support the next videos. Let's go back to the lesson. Here, and we are going to set the price of the orange. Let me change the text of this button to update context, because that's the name of the variable, the function we are going to be using now. And in this way, we can also set a variable. Let me show how. We have update context, that's the name of the function. Then we have to pass the brackets, so open brackets. One second, I'm not used to these keyboards. Here is close brackets and close parentheses. And inside these brackets, then we can set the name of the variable. I'm going to say price orange. And then we are going to get from also another input. Let me insert the input here. Insert text input. Just move here right below this part. Let's say it's named txt orange. Okay, so now in the update context function, we are going to set the price orange value to be txt orange.text. So now once the user clicks here, the text inside this text input will go to price orange. Let me remove this default, and I'm going to put a label here with this variable. Insert text label right below, and in this case is price orange. It already shows because I already created the function here. Even though I didn't click, we can see it's blank because I didn't click yet, but the variable is already in there. It just doesn't have any value. If I play the app, let's say it's 3 and click on update contexts, then it will set the variable to 3. And I could use it to do other things inside this page. What's the difference between those? The difference is set is used globally in all the app, all the pages, while the variable used in update context is just used in this page. If I go to another screen and try to insert a label accessing the price of the orange, it won't work because it's a local variable, meaning it just works in the other screen. Price, it doesn't even show orange. See, it's an error because it doesn't exist. This screen doesn't recognize that that variable was instantiated anywhere. So why don't we use always set if it doesn't give that problem? Because we don't want variables being used in places that are not necessary. We don't want another screen to see some value that's used only in this screen and also give the chance of other screen overwriting. So in this case, we use update context if we want to be using only in this page. That's the difference. If we click here in this X icon in the left, we have the variables, and we can also see global variables. We have here price pineapple, and we see that the value is 4. And context variables, inside the learning variables screen, we have the context variable called price orange. Right, so it shows here in this pane. This was the introduction about variables. In the next class, we are going to see how we are going to use it to edit a record from a gallery in a form. See you in there.